Hello viewers, today we are going to talk about consumer in the market. Now many people will have a feeling, who is a consumer, who is a customer? Now a customer is a person who will purchase. He may not be the end user, but a consumer is a person who consumes or who uses the product. Suppose if a father purchases a baby soap to the baby, he is the customer, but the consumer is the baby. So here when we distinguish consumer in the market, it is very difficult to tap what the consumer wants it. The growing trend, economic development, takes a vital place to tap the customer. When we talk about the product here, a product may be a good, a service, or an idea. So when we talk about these three things, you have to retain the customer with a good quality of good and good service and a very good idea. So a customer is a king in the market. Then when we talk about customer, it is the changing trends and the income pattern, growth in the economic development, and technology is improving. The customer is changing from one pattern to the another pattern. That is consumer buying habits. Here I'm talking about the buying habits. The buying habit is moving because they are not looking only the price. They want the design of the product, quality of the product, and the trendiness in the product. And it is very difficult what type of product should be prepared and to be presented before the customer according to this price, quality, design, color. Not only this, now the younger generation people are coming into the picture. They are taking the decisions. Earlier, a father used to take the decision to purchase any product. Take right from the essential good till the speciality good. But nowadays, children and teenagers, they are coming into the picture and they want what they want to buy. This is making the seller as well as the producer a $1 million question. What to be produced? What to be given? Not only this, competition is another one. The products which are competing. So when the customer is looking for more products, his habits are also changing because you have a choice. If you want to buy a slipper, you have n number of varieties of slippers you can see in the shoe mart. Because just for a Hawaii slipper only, they are having n number of colors, designs, and with all fashion. So the customer is in confusion what to buy. At the same time, the producer also confused in what the customer wants. Another one is the income plays a vital role. As the customer's income level is increasing, as we have the structure, low level, middle level and higher level. The low level people, they go more for the essentials. And the middle level people, they have a priority of the products like essentials. Which are minimum, that is education, health care, transportation, and food, other things. And not only they are concentrating this priority goods, but also they are concentrating to the lifestyle essentials. Nowadays, if a student wants to go to college, he wants mobile. It's not essential, but lifestyle essential, because the way he wants to live, and he wants two-wheeler to go to a college. He is not even earning. And he wants a laptop. And he wants a pen drive. All these things is a part of the lifestyle. So consumer habits are changing according to the lifestyle. So when we talk about the consumer buying habits, they also comparing with the other people. Status goods, and also the culture, the social environment, all these are playing a vital role where a customer is moving from one level to the another level. This is about the customer buying habits. So here, when we talk about the customer buying habits, as it is changing, and the producers and sellers also should tap these type of customers, and they are also changing their product according to that. Once the customer stop buying one product and the producer cannot sell the product, he should stop producing the product. If you take example of pages, earlier when there was no mobile, pages were produced. The pager used to give information, but to substitute the pager, mobiles have started and there is no sale for the pagers. Then it has been removed. So the mobile has dominated. Now when we talk about the mobile, again not only to say hello, you can message, now photos you can take, all this, so many gadgets, so many things are there in one mobile, touch screen. So these habits are changing because of the lifestyle is changing and the status is increasing the income level. These are all are playing a vital role where the consumer habits are changing because of the change of the economic development. So this is about the consumer buying habits. Now we'll move on to the consumer buying motives. What is a motive? A motive is an urge, a feeling to have it, which will make the customer to purchase the product. That is called the motive. So when we talk about the motives, there are two motives, internal motives and external motives. What is an internal motive? Internal motive is personal feeling, rational buying. Then what he thinks about the product, his choice, that is the internal motive. For example, ice cream. In ice cream, you like vanilla, somebody likes butterscotch, another likes strawberry, another likes mango. That is the internal feeling, personal feeling. Each customer will have the feeling, tastes are preference. When the taste and preferences are changing, then these internal motives will get affected. And today you want one and tomorrow you want a different flavor because the preference is different. These are all things which comes under the internal motives. Internal means imbibe, which is there in the customer feeling and which is suitable to him according to his style, his way of living, he prefers. Next is external motives. External motives are the external environment, like social environment, society, income, family, culture, religion. All these things will play a vital role for the external factors. Suppose if your income has increased from 10,000 to all of a sudden to 40,000. Earlier you used to go by two-wheeler. Now immediately you switch on to the four-wheeler and ordinary colored television to LED TV, because the external factors which are driving, income increases, family force will be there, then the status will be increased. These are the things which plays a vital role for the external motives. According to Malvin Hattrick, he classified primary buying motives and secondary buying motives. When we talk about primary buying motives, he said,
food and drink, comfort, welfare of beloved ones, freedom from fear and danger, to be superior, social approval, to live longer. Next, we'll move on to the secondary buying motives. These motives are those which are influenced by the society where he is born and lives. It is created after fulfilling the basic needs. Secondary buying motive examples such as bargains, information, cleanliness, efficiency, convenience, dependability, quality, style, beauty, and curiosity.
So he classified several other things also, what are primary and what are secondary motives. For these external motives and the internal motives, what is very important is here, how you are going to choose your product. Some people, they like the product package. If packing is good, it is safe, secured, insect free. For example, milk packet, now you are getting in tetra packets. A milk is a perishable good, you are getting in tetra packet. What is that? Packing is making a lot of difference. You can use for a week, not only for a one day or the, and in during summer, it is giving. 7 days you can use, keep that tetra packet. So packaging, the product package. Some people like color. They like the color of the product or the packaging color or the design, shape, quality. All these things plays a vital role when you choose a product. Then move on to the patronage. Patronage means they are very, very choosy to buy only to go to that particular store. They will not buy in any other store. They believe that that store is giving a very, very good quality, very good sales service, after sales service, and they are very cordially, gives lot of importance to the customers. That is customer care. Then you feel like going to the same store and you want to buy. That is called the patronage. This comes out of like status or brand, because the brand products are sold in that particular market only. That is about the patronage. Next is emotional. When we talk about emotional buying, emotionally in the sense when we talk about somebody is having, even I want to have, my neighbor has got LED TV, I want to have immediately, or my neighbor has got grand sari, 10,000 worth, even I want it. Emotional, by looking at the others which is not having with you, or jealousy, or you want to give to your loved ones, you want to show off, you want to show you are very big shot, you are giving a valuable gift. These are all called emotional motives. We also call as impulse buying. Impulse means you will not plan for that. By looking at others, you want to buy it. Actually, it is not there in your mind to purchase. But somebody is having, even I should have. That is what we call it as emotional buying or emotional motive. And the next one is rational. Rational means very judgmental, very planned. He will compare, or the buyer, the consumer will compare with 10 people before he purchases any product. Like car, for example, he will ask several people which car, which model, which company car is good, giving longevity, good service, after sale service, and the color which he wants is very judgmental. Quality, price, everything he will judge, and he will plan for the payments also, then he will purchase that product. So these are the four which plays an external factors, that is product, patronage, emotional and rational. Next, we'll go to the consumer products. Now, what are consumer products? When we talk about consumer product, as I told you already, a product can be a good service or an idea. When we talk about good, good means any good. If you take milk, egg, bread, any good, we call it as a product. But a service, service in the sense transportation, telecommunication, internet services, all these comes under the services. So the services also comes under the product. Next is idea. What is an idea? Suppose you want to construct a building. a consultancy will be given, an idea, a plan will be given. Here we have a combination of good as well as service. Suppose if you go to a hotel, they serve the good, you'll have the breakfast, and also the services included, both are there. So a customer product is very, very important. How he will choose, what are the different types of products here? Based on this products, you have convenience product. The convenience product is that product which daily the customer uses this product, because he wants to have, it comes under the essential product like milk, butter, bread, eggs. All these are very essential. This is called convenience product. So every day he has to buy in small quantities, and he cannot store for longer time, and every day he will be purchasing the milk and all other things which are very essentials. Next is shopping goods. Shopping goods are those goods occasionally we will go. Suppose it's a birthday or any marriage, or you are going outside tour, you want to have certain products which are not there. Example, clothes, footwear, then any mobiles or any electronic goods which are not there in your house or which were worn out, that means damaged, you want to replace. These are called shopping goods. And very rarely you will be purchasing, not oftenly. So we spend lot of time, which one is very important, and you will buy these products. That is about shopping products. Now we'll move on to specialty goods. Specialty goods are very rarely we purchase. Suppose you want to buy a jewelry, you have saved since 5 years the money, and now you want to purchase a very good heavy jewelry. It's a specialty. You look at a quality, then brand, then which is very good, pattern, design, because you cannot change as you like it once you purchase it. So you call it as specialty, because once you purchase, you cannot withdraw. Double door refrigerator, which is very costly, 70,000, 56,000. And speciality, and you want to see all the features are intact or not, and you give lot of importance, lot of time you'll spend to purchase that speciality goods. So these are the main: convenience goods, shopping goods, speciality goods. And you have other goods which are emergency goods. Emergency goods, you'll not plan for that goods. It is only comes due to emergency. Example, your grandmother is fell ill, she cannot walk, then you have to buy a walker, and you have to give some other instruments which are very important, her to move, a wheelchair. These are the emergency goods. So this is how the goods are mainly divided into convenience product, shopping goods, specialty goods, and emergency goods. Now another important aspect is product promotion practices. In the market, how to promote the product is very difficult, because the customer should know the information, the customer awareness, and to tell the customer that our product is different from others. For that, the first one is advertising. And advertising is a paid communication, and you have different ways of advertising through mass media, and the advertising is through newspapers, magazines, and nowadays through SMS. There are the different ways to advertise the product and tell the people that what is about the product. And the next one is sales promotion. The main aim of the sales promotion is they want short sales. They want to sell in a very short time. So for that, they want to attract the customers by giving discounts and by giving schemes, that is buy one, get one free. So the multi-storied or supermarkets, want to clear their sale, they'll have the sale promotion activities. And this is mainly to attract the new customers and also the brand switchers, we call. Some people, they switch on very easily to from one brand to the another brand. So they want to make maximum sales through the sales promotion activity. And next one is public relation. When we talk about the public relation, here public relation is very important to tell the customer that we have still in touch with you. And they want to give warm feeling that suppose if you go to any shop, you want to buy any good, there they'll give you a small slip and they ask you to write your name, your birthday or your children's birthday. And they remember those dates and they will send a SMS or they will pass a message that wish you happy birthday. That means they are having the public relation. And next is direct marketing. Direct marketing means directly the manufacturer to the customer. Here you don't have any middleman. They don't trust in intermediaries. They want to give the maximum, the best price, product, quality to the customer. So the customer feel that it is right from the production department. Any queries, it has been given to these people, the manufacturer, any defect or any modification, there will be a direct contact. So this is about how the promotional strategies are made for the product. And the last one is the consumer facing nowadays problems when they purchase the goods. So there are many, many reasons why a customer is not switching or continuing with the same brand. Because of adulteration is malpractices. Sellers are exploiting the customers. How the ways are different. MRP, they sell above the MRP price. It is very difficult to the customer which is the product is good and he should not get cheated by the seller. That's why the Consumer Protection Act has come. And if you have any queries, you can also give a message to the Consumer Protection Act against any sellers. The people who are taking advantage, not only the sellers, the manufacturers and the sellers, they buy from manufacturers and sell the goods. They produce bulk in quantities with a very cheap quality and with a low price to attract the customers. Online purchases also will give certain defective goods. And it is very difficult to the customers to go and to whom it has to be represented. And the customers in this regard, they are getting cheated by the sellers as well as the producers for their product. So to be awareness, the customer should judge before he purchases and he has to take care of the rational buying method instead of emotional buying. This is what is very important when you talk about how the customers are getting cheated. This is how the consumer in the market nowadays facing a lot of problems regarding the products, malpractices by the sellers or the producers. And here we have to conclude with this. The consumer should be aware. He should not be emotional and he should not take any decisions which is very partial or only looking at the price or trendiness or to the color. He should have the judgment and he should take the decision concerning with the other people in the family members as well as in the society or your neighbors or to their peers or the friends. It is your money, your income, which you are going to lose. And you have to take a right decision in purchasing the products. The customer is the main person. He is treated as a king of the market. And he has given a lot of importance to buy these products. Thank you.